Yeah, it looks like we got the new memory in today. Let's see how we can do this one-handed here. Memory Edge Tech. There's my new memory. You get to install this in the computer, make the laptop actually work so I can continue editing my videos. Let's see. And these are look like they're blue in color. The epoxy board's blue. There's 8 memory chips on each side. They're 8 gigabytes per card for a total of 16. So that means about 500 megabytes per chip. It's supposed to be fairly fast memory. PC3L. Hopefully this will make the laptop not keep bottlenecking. Made in America. Oh, I love to see that stuff. Right there. Made in America. You see that? Made in America. We need to have more products made in America. Well, as you can see, it's a little bit glitchy. And I'll go ahead and shut everything down. Another reason why we're replacing the memory is because when we go to shut things down, they don't shut down. There we go. And not responding. Come on, computer. Shut down. Application is not responding. Program may respond again if you wait. And there we go. You got no memory, it won't do anything. Including load the desktop. There's a picture of my spring project. Come on, computer. Come on, you can do it. Shut down. And then when it gets shut down, we can flip it over and open up the memory slot. No, I'm Well, I gotta start off by removing 18 screws. The screws are already missing. Lovely. And that one's already missing. How come my laptop is missing screws? Nothing magnetic.
Is my little ride screwdriver magnetic?
Take the CD ROM drive out. Now let's see what we got here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 screws. So I'm missing at least five. Oh, there's another one. Missing four screws. There's another one, so that's 13 screws. Why does that screw tighten but not loosen? Wow. Move the battery. Right there. Right there is why it was ratcheting, not loosening. Here you got three ribbon cables. This one down here. This one up here. And that one over there. And you need to release these. Lift up. Lift up. And this one down here is slide straight back. There's the top of the laptop. Okay. have to release the hard drive, take that out. Take this board right here out. You got your Wi-Fi antennas right here. Fan. Power wire to your display. Fan up and out. Okay, fan still held in by wires. We'll remove the or not remove. Smaller screwdriver bit than that. Wow. That tiny little screw. This little tiny one right here with the super flat head holds down your Wi-Fi card. There. Screw right there for your hard drive. Another screw right there for your hard drive. Slide the hard drive back this way to disengage it. Screw right here in the corner. Something is still held down here. thing in. Put this over, and there's our memory slots. And you want to make sure that when you remove your memory, you push these little tabs right here back. You have to do both at the same time, and that'll make your memory card snap up. And go ahead and remove it. Take your memory card sleeve. First one, you see the slot on this side right here, line it up with the groove, slide it all the way in, push it down until it clicks in both sides. Repeat the same thing on this side over here. Sure it's all the way down in before pushing it down a click, and then we can go ahead and carefully flip this back over again. Same principle as memory, so we got to make sure that not pinching anything anywhere. And a tiny little flat screw. The oddball. Everything else is down. Start putting all your screws back in, reverse sequence. Two hard drive screws. Slide the hard drive forward. Engage it down here first. Here the hard drive is to sit into, and then it slides forward. Let's see if we can figure out why that one. Doesn't seem to want to thread in. Sure nothing is pinched, too skinny, tunnel screws, right in the next side of the fan. Check, check, double check, make sure nothing's going to get pinched. All right, all wires are down in. Cool. Everything's where it's supposed to be. Cool. This is supposed to be right there. Get one of these long screws. I'm gonna bring this up through the bottom and into this first. Okay, I want you to get a close-up of this. That little screw right there. That piece is what I got a little tricked up on. Same thing over on this side. So those stay in there. Tricky, tricky. We'll show you those when we get back to the other side. Make sure you don't forget this silver screw right here in this corner. That should take care of all of your silver screws. All you have left remaining is black screws. Those all go on the outside, so put your keyboard back on. Make sure these locks are undone or it won't go in. Thank you. They are a little tricky. Once you're satisfied you've got all your connections together, everything's clipped together nice and tight, close it, flip it over, and start putting in all your little black screws. Once you got all of those back in, there's a total of 18 all together. Make sure you put your CD-ROM drive in. We'll take care of that right now. Make sure this is the right way. Yep. Screw right there in the middle. I do remember when we started off, we were missing a few, so. Once you're satisfied that you've got all your screws back in, go ahead and put your battery back in. And go ahead and power it up, make sure that everything works. Mouse works. Okay, let's go to control panel. Device manager. Good all the way down through here. The system installed memory 16 gigabytes. And there you have it. How to upgrade the memory in your laptop computer. Thank you.
Yes, I did.